Hello, I am Cindy Powell, and I'm a material scientist here at the Pacific Northwest National Laboratory. I'd like to welcome you today to the High Throughput Materials Discovery Laboratory. Here at PNNL, we are at the forefront in the search for next generation better batteries. Combining a deep expertise in material science with a thorough understanding of the requirements of batteries by end-use applications that include grid storage all the way to electric vehicles, we have the knowledge to be able to develop and deliver next generation better battery technologies. In addition to that, PNNL is also recognized for its collection of energy storage analytical tools, which can be used by utilities and other battery end users to fully understand the value and the impact of deploying next generation battery technologies. Here in the High Throughput Laboratory, we are focused on the discovery and the development of next generation battery materials for flow battery applications. Now, flow batteries are a little bit different from the batteries that you're probably more familiar with that you might use in your cell phone or in your electric vehicle. For one thing, flow batteries are a lot bigger. Depending on the application, flow batteries can be as big as requiring train car size containers in order to hold them. Another thing is that they are relatively inexpensive. To create better batteries for flow battery applications, we leverage the power of artificial intelligence and machine learning to sift through the literally millions of possible chemistry combinations that could be used to make the next generation of better batteries. Because cost is very important, we intentionally avoid considering the addition of hard to find rare earth elements or expensive critical materials, always keeping in mind that the end use needs to be very affordable. Once we've identified a suite of chemistries that we think in theory have the potential to be better batteries, we bring them into this laboratory and we put Albert and Beverly to work. This is Albert. Albert and his twin sister Beverly on the other side of the laboratory are robots, and their official name is High Throughput Experimentation System. But because we're a lot less formal here in the laboratory, we just call them Albert and Beverly. So Albert and Beverly's jobs are to take those chemistries that we view through our computational efforts to have very high potential to be next generation battery materials. And they make those materials and test them to validate whether they do in fact have what it takes to be a better battery. As you can see, Albert is already hard at work while we're talking here to make the electrolytes and to test their properties to confirm whether or not they have the performance that we require. Of course, Albert and Beverly are robots, and they are very accurate in the work that they do. And the good news too is that they have the ability to work 7 days a week, 24 hours a day, which really frees up the time of their human collaborators to spend more of their time and energy analyzing test results and putting more effort into the design of the next generation of better flow battery technologies. Using this approach, we recently discovered a new class of what we think are going to be better flow battery materials called fluorinones. This is fluorinone. Fluorinone is not a new material. In fact, it's already used in a wide variety of different applications, from LEDs to pharmaceuticals. Fluorinones have not historically been known to be battery materials, but with a little bit of PNNL ingenuity, we've been able to engineer this particular fluorinone material to become what looks like a better battery material. It's still early days in terms of testing, but we will continue to develop this fluorinone material and expose it to increasingly rigorous grid scale battery requirements to prove that in fact it is a better battery material. Of course, the best way to really understand how to build a better battery is to engage with grid operators, battery manufacturers, and other end users to understand what is really required in battery performance in real application. PNNL recently joined forces with Energy Northwest, a regional utilities company, and 2C Energy Services, which is a woman-owned energy company based in Seattle, to form a project that is the state of Washington's first utility scale demonstration of the combination of solar and battery technology called the Horn Rapids Solar Storage and Training Project. Funded in part by the Washington Clean Energy Fund, the project's goal is to prove that the combination of solar and battery technologies can deliver to utility customers electricity that is predictable, reliable, and clean. In addition to that, this project has a training component and will provide both solar and battery technicians with hands-on experience in plant construction, plant operations, and in maintenance. In addition to the development of better battery materials for grid storage applications, PNNL is also focused on other applications to include batteries for electric vehicles. To tell you more about our research in this area, I turn to my colleague, Dr. Jay Zhao.
The goal of Battery 500 Consortium is to double the cell level energy of traditional lithium ion batteries, achieving 500 watt hour per kilogram. To meet this goal, no matter what kind of a chemistry is being used in the battery, we have to use lithium metal as the anode. This is why Battery 500 Consortium only focuses on lithium metal battery technology. PNNL currently is leading Battery 500 Consortium for the Department of Energy. We have world-class scientists, including two Nobel Prize winners, working together to advance lithium metal battery technology. In phase one of Battery 500 Consortium, we have four national labs and five universities in the core team, plus 10 seedling projects across the country to support this effort. We also have industrial advisory board, including Tesla, IBM, and US Advanced Battery Consortium, to review our progress and gauge our R&D. Chrysler, GM, and Ford are all members of USABC. In our Battery 500 Consortium, all the new materials and new concepts are being validated in high-energy, realistic pouch cells. The prototype batteries that have been developed under our consortium have already achieved 350 watt hour per kilogram as well as 400 watt hour per kilogram with a world record cycling stability. The reason we use pouch cell, realistic pouch cell, to validate all the new concepts is because this allows us to make sure that all the new discoveries and the new findings are relevant to industry applications. Not only we have great scientists working together to advance future battery technologies, as a national lab, we also have first-class scientific tools to visualize the materials in a working battery. For example, our scientists have developed in-situ transmission electron microscope to monitor the electron materials in a functioning battery. We found that for some of the battery materials during charge, the volume of the particles expanded significantly and broke into pieces. This is definitely bad news for battery application, but based on this fundamental understanding, our scientists were able to redesign and modify the battery materials to accommodate such huge volume exchange, so we can extend the cycling stability of the batteries. Again, all the materials, redesigned materials, are being cross-validated by using realistic pouch cells, so industry can repeat and adopt our battery technologies conveniently.
Because of PNNL's expertise and abilities to build better batteries, combined with our deep understanding of grid operations and the requirements of next generation energy grids, the Department of Energy recently selected PNNL to be the home of its grid storage launch pad. The goal of the grid storage launch pad is to accelerate the development of next generation better battery materials and systems through rigorous validation under realistic operating conditions up to the 100 kilowatt scale. Also important with the grid storage launch pad is collaboration with a variety of partners to include end users like grid operators, battery manufacturers, but also with research partners from academia and other national laboratories. PNNL has a rich portfolio of intellectual property focused on battery materials and systems that includes 200 patent applications to date. 54 patents have been granted, and PNNL currently holds 24 licenses with private sector business entities focused on further developing battery technologies. And with that, I'd like to thank you for joining me. I hope you enjoyed learning more about the batteries research at the Pacific Northwest National Laboratory.